Keep distant. My own demons haunt me too closely. I cannot also bear the burden of yours.
I've got sword fighters, mages, archers, all willing to fight by your side if the price is right.
Be on your way now, my dear. Perhaps we'll have matters to discuss again later.
Second time's a charm? Or have I asked too much of you?
Go on, then. Ring. Was it the death fog that got them, or something else?
The spirit of a Black Ring Reaver looks down at his corpse in dismay. He notices you approach and challenges you in a throaty rasp.
You're not one of those blood things. Who are you? You look the part, I suppose. We had orders to take the island at any cost. We had spells and charms that were supposed to protect us from the death fog. They didn't work. Half of us died crossing the water. Me and some others. Just barely made it. But then these blood beasts attacked us right away. A few made it away. I didn't. Orders. We were told they'd work. No reason to doubt that. One of my comrades used source magic that saved the rest of us. The death fog already burnt my lungs. But I made it ashore.
The Reaver's spirit wheezes and coughs.
I've spotted something.
Much knowledge, so much history. I could get lost in these tomes.
I've spotted something.
The spirit urgently passes a hand across the spines, whispering each tome's title as she comes across it.
No, no, it isn't here. This is impossible. You, my brother, help me find it. There is little time. This is no time to feign ignorance, my friend. The Doctor's arrogance may end us all. He has released a dark presence upon us. It must never sing the taming. The hymnals must be destroyed. And yet, I see no sign one was ever here. You must help me look.
Her hands fan furiously across the tomes like a pianist's upon the keys.
The key, of course. The melody that douses the guardian flames and reveals the vaults. I shudder to think what may happen should their captives be freed. I have presided over this archive for many years. The hymnals were many. How could I not notice their absence? You must be feverish, though I wouldn't be surprised. Dr. Deva was surely ill to risk all that he's built here. Now be silent. Your questions vex me, and I have no time for idle chatter.
She hushes you with an index finger held to your lips and continues her search.
Yes.
Thank you.
I can feel my source power draining at the mirror's touch.
Another pyramid. How very useful.
The transparent artifact glimmers of its own accord, as if conducting light from another world, another plane of living. As your hand nears it, it shivers and speaks. Your head perks. You know these words. This is the language of demons. Few have heard it spoken aloud.
Connected as one. The past and the present slave. Absolution and redemption await the one whose sins are many.
It's a crystal blade, seemingly separated from its hilt. It's clearly of a kind with the object you recovered from the Surrey tomb. The object repeats the words it previously spoke. It has nothing more to offer.
The hilt of a blade, I do believe. But clearly no ordinary blade.
The statue is a striking sight, a sizzling blue totem on a blood-red isle. Even stranger, a shard of polished iron peeks from under the statue's base. There's something hidden beneath this massive sculpture. Looking closer, you notice the statue's clerical garb, so similar to that worn by the ghostly priests bonded to the isle, an unlikely coincidence. Nothing happens. The flame still burns, and the statue still stands. The hymn twines around the effigy like a fine thread. Guardian burning bright with sourceful flame, abide the sacred call, reveal the godsless hall. Winged keeper, song doth bid you break. The priest shall scry the demon's lies, the chains await their captive. From stone to dust, from stone to dust.
Like a charm.
The flaming figure emits no heat, yet your skin seems to sizzle if you draw too near. Nothing happens. The flame still burns. The hymn twines around the effigy. Winged keep from stone. You might expect the stone figure was. Nothing happens. The flame. The hymn twines. Winged from stone.
Be one of those forts.
The spirit of a young robed man paces the chamber anxiously. He sees you approach. A look of trepidation crosses his spectral features.
Did my order send you to cure the child?
The spirit falters, momentarily lost for words. Finally, he musters a nod.
I was hungry and thirsty for days. Then I rested. When I woke up next to my corpse, I thought I was delirious. I hoped I was delirious. But eventually I realized what had happened. Some form of demon seized her and nested inside her mind. She cannot speak or move. We did what we could to help, but we could not risk provoking the beast within. We can find her here until a way to safely remove the demon could be found. It was my duty to watch over her, but I was never relieved of that duty. She has no family that we know of. All she had was a pet cat. That poor girl's life is drifting past her, thanks to that demon. Her cell is just over there. I can let you in, but are you sure you can help her? What are you going to do? My brothers were confident they could help her as well, but they still had to lock her up here in the end. But nobody else is coming to help, are they? I'll let you in, but promise me one thing. Whatever happens, take her away from this place. Far away. Please, I've waited a long time for this. I need a real answer.
The spirit can't help but smile.
I knew you had good in you, the moment I laid eyes on you. Come, I'll let you in. Take good care of her. Bring her somewhere peaceful. Don't disturb the demon within her. There's no telling what could happen if it breaks free.
Go on then.
The priest has scried the demon's lies.